Hello students, today we will continue with the chapter on consumer's equilibrium. As discussed earlier, there are two approaches to consumer's equilibrium. One is the marginal utility analysis and second is the indifference curve analysis. We have already studied marginal utility analysis. Today we will be studying the indifference curve analysis. The indifference curve approach was originally developed by an Indian economist, Pareto, and subsequently developed fully by the British economists J.R. Hicks and R.G.D. Allen. Indifference curve analysis has adopted the concept of ordinal utility instead of the concept of cardinal utility. It means that the consumer is capable of comparing the utility derived from various commodities. Thus, it is based on the idea of a given scale of preference of the consumer as between different combinations of two commodities. The consumer's scale of preferences is independent of the prices ruling in the market. He builds up his scale of preferences from the commodities he consumes and knows that one combination of the goods which yield him the same satisfaction as the other. This analysis is also called new analysis or substitution analysis. An indifference curve represents satisfaction of a consumer for two commodities. It is drawn on the assumption that for all possible points on the indifference curve, the total satisfaction or utility remains the same. In other words, the consumer is indifferent among all the combinations which give him the same level of satisfaction. An indifference curve is also called iso-utility curve. Indifference curve is also based on certain assumptions. The assumptions are, the consumer is a rational person who aims at getting the maximum satisfaction from the commodities that he is consuming. Secondly, the indifference curve analysis is based on ordinal approach. That is, the consumer's scale of preferences is so complete that he is able to choose any one of the two combinations of the commodities. Consumer is not oversupplied with the commodities in question and he will always prefer more to less quantity of the commodity. Consumer's choices are assumed to be consistent or transitive. It means that if a consumer considers a product A better than B and B better than C, obviously he will prefer C to B if this choice is open. To get the same level of satisfaction, if the consumer increases the quantity of a commodity, he must decrease the quantity of the other commodity. And lastly, indifference curve analysis assumes that there is perfect competition in the market. We now have an indifference schedule. It is a table which shows the various combinations of two commodities where the person is getting the same level of satisfaction. For example, let's take combination A. The products under this are considered as apples and oranges. If the consumer takes one apple, then he can buy 10 oranges. Another combination is 2 apples and 7 oranges. Third combination is 3 apples and 5 oranges. And last combination D gives 4 apples and 4 oranges. Now these combinations give the same level of satisfaction to the consumer. That means he is indifferent to these combinations. So he may opt for A, B, C or D, any of these combinations. This indifference curve is now represented in graph. On the x-axis, we take the number of apples. On y-axis, we take the number of oranges. So, IC represents the indifference curve and it is this indifference curve represents a diagrammatic representation of the indifference schedule. Now IC, or the indifference curve, is a line that shows all possible combinations of two goods between which a person is indifferent. For example, at the point of A, where we have 10 oranges and 1 apple, point B shows 2 apples, 7 oranges, point C shows 3 apples and 5 oranges, and point D, which shows 4 apples and 4 oranges. We can draw similar indifference curves showing the combinations of apples and oranges, which give greater and lesser satisfaction than the one shown previously. Now we can draw these combinations with the same level of income. The person is able to buy a certain number of oranges and apples. If he increases his income, then there would be another set of combinations where he might increase the combination, he might increase the consumption of both apples and oranges. Thus there will be a different indifference curve which will be higher than the current indifference curve. So when these different indifference curves are shown in the same diagram, it is known as an indifference map. Thus a set of indifference curves is called an indifference map. The next slide will show us the indifference map, which consists of various indifference curves which are represented by IC1, IC2, IC3, etc. Each of the indifference curves represents a different level of satisfaction. The further the curve from the origin, the higher is the level of satisfaction it represents. For example, IC3 is higher than IC2, which means that all points on IC3 yield a higher level of satisfaction than the points on IC2. It should be noted here that we cannot say how much utility the higher curve represents, because if we could, we shall be making a cardinal measurement of utility. Thus, the aggregate utilities can be ranked but not measured. From the indifference schedule, we see that when we move from one combination to the other, we are substituting some units of one commodity for some units of the other. The MRS, marginal rate of substitution, shows how much of one commodity is substituted for how much of another by a consumer without changing the level of satisfaction. In Hick's words, we may define marginal rate of substitution of commodity X for commodity Y is the quantity of commodity Y which would just compensate the consumer for the loss of the marginal utility utility of commodity X. Generally, it is observed that as we come to have more and more of one commodity, we have to forego less and less of the other, since our desire for the former becomes less and less with more and more of it. Technically, this is said that the marginal rate of substitution of commodity X for commodity Y will fall as we have more of X and less of Y. This will be represented by the price ratio of the two commodities. The slope of indifference curve shows the marginal rate of substitution between these two commodities, while the slope of the budget line shows the ratio between the prices of the two commodities. Therefore, we can also express the consumer's equilibrium as the MRS, which is marginal rate of substitution, which can be represented as the price ratio of the two commodities. If we consider the given in different schedule where apples and oranges are represented, there are various combinations A to D which represent the different combinations, like combination A which represents 1 apple and 10 oranges. In this case, the marginal rate of substitution is not considered. Then another combination B, which is 2 apples and 7 oranges. In this case, as we increase the number of apples to 2 units from 1, the amount of oranges become less from 10 to 7. Therefore, for 1 unit of apple, we are decreasing the quantity of orange by 3. So in this case, the marginal rate of substitution becomes 1:3. In the third case, combination C, there are 3 apples and 5 oranges. Now in this case, as we increase 1 unit of apple, we forego 2 units of oranges, which is 1:2 again. Then the D combination, where we have 4 apples and 4 oranges, the marginal rate of substitution becomes 1:1. We will now consider the properties of indifference curves. An indifference curve slopes downwards from left to right. When a consumer decides to have more units of one commodity, he will have to reduce the number of units of the other commodity if he has to maintain on the same indifference curve. This results in the negative slope of the curve, that is downward sloping. Another property is that indifference curve is convex to the origin. Convexity implies that the curve bows inwards to the origin. The implication of this convexity is that as we have more and more of commodity X and less of Y, the marginal rate of substitution of X for Y goes on falling. Normally, we observe that the consumer's willingness to sacrifice a commodity is lower when the stock of the commodity with him is less. If we see from the table, as we move down from combination A to D, the consumer is consuming less and less of oranges and more of apples. Considering the diminishing marginal rate of substitution, the rate at which the consumer is willing to give up further apples, further oranges to get more apples diminishes. Higher indifference curve yields higher satisfaction. Indifference curve which lies above and to the right of another indifference curve gives a higher level of satisfaction than the lower one. Higher indifference curve gives those combinations which yield more satisfaction than the combinations on the lower indifference curve. Two indifference curves never intersect each other. This follows from the fact that each indifference curve represents different level of satisfaction, so they do not intersect each other. If two indifference curves intersect each other, it means that a combination of two goods at the point of intersection would also give two different levels of satisfaction, which is not possible. The budget line or price line. In pursuit of obtaining satisfaction, a consumer is governed by his budget. That is, the amount of money he has to spend on the commodities and the prices of the commodities in the market. This information helps us to draw a budget line. Let us suppose that a consumer has the budget of rupees 100 to spend on apples and oranges. There would be a certain amount of per apple and per orange. So let us suppose first the person takes all his money and buys only apples. So in this case, we get the point N on the given curve, and suppose the person now he doesn't buy only apples. He buys only oranges with the amount of money that he has. So then this combination is shown by the point M on the curve. So we draw a straight line from N to M, which reflects the budget line or the price line. Any point which is outside the given price line, like for example H, it will be beyond the reach of the consumer as he doesn't have the budget to go beyond this price line. Similarly, any point which is below the given line, for example the point K which is shown in the curve, it shows that it is underspending by the consumer. The person has budget till the line M and H, but he is not utilizing the budget to the point K which is below the price line. It shows that the person is not spending according to his budget. His budget is still lying unutilized with him. So no rational producer will like to not use his budget to the full extent to derive maximum satisfaction. So the line M and N and M shows that this is the level where the consumer is able to utilize his budget to the maximum extent. Before we explain how a consumer reaches equilibrium position, we have to make certain assumptions. These assumptions are as follows. The scale of preferences of the consumer for the two commodities remains the same throughout the analysis. The consumer has a given and constant sum of money to spend on the two commodities. And if he does not spend it on one commodity, he has to spend on the other. The prices of the two commodities remain the same during our analysis. The commodities considered are homogeneous and divisible. And lastly, the consumer acts rationally. That is, he tries to maximize his satisfaction with the given level of resources. Before we explain how a consumer reaches equilibrium position, we have to make certain assumptions. These assumptions are as follows. The scale of preferences of the consumer for the two commodities remains the same throughout the analysis. The consumer has a given and constant sum of money to spend on the two commodities. And if he does not spend it on one commodity, he has to spend on the other. The prices of the two commodities remain the same during our analysis. The commodities considered are homogeneous and divisible. And lastly, the consumer acts rationally. That is, he tries to maximize his satisfaction with the given level of resources. Before we explain how a consumer reaches equilibrium position, we have to make certain assumptions. These assumptions are as follows. The scale of preferences of the consumer for the two commodities remains the same throughout the analysis. The consumer has a given and constant sum of money to spend on the two commodities. And if he does not spend it on one commodity, he has to spend on the other. The prices of the two commodities remain the same during our analysis. The commodities considered are homogeneous and divisible. And lastly, the consumer acts rationally. That is, he tries to maximize his satisfaction with the given level of resources. A consumer attains equilibrium when he maximizes his total utility given his income and the prices of the two commodities. We now combine the indifference curves and the budget line on the same diagram. Now P and L represents the price line and the various combinations are reflected by R, S, Q, T and H on the indifference curve. The indifference curve which touches the price line at point Q is the level where the consumer attains equilibrium. The price line which is tangent to the curve, that point is point Q, and the quantity of good Y is N and the quantity of good X will be M in the given case. The tangency point which is Q, the slope of the price line PL and the indifference curve IC3 are all equal at this point. Now the slope of indifference curve shows the marginal rate of substitution of X commodity for Y commodity. Now in this case the marginal rate of substitution for both commodities will be the marginal utility of X equated with the price upon marginal utility of Y, which is equal to the price of X divided by the price of Y. The highest indifference curve with the point on the budget line is the one that just touches it. This is the point Q, which is the tangency point given the highest level of utility. This is the point of consumer's equilibrium, because at this point the slopes of the price line and the indifference curve are equal. It is also necessary that at the point of tangency, the marginal rate of substitution must be diminishing. Otherwise, equilibrium achieved will not be a stable equilibrium. A rational consumer will try to conform to the indifference curve technique, but in real life, he may not be able to do so. This is due to many reasons. Indifference curve approach is forced to make unrealistic assumption that the consumer possesses complete knowledge of all his scale of preferences. Another reason is the indifference curve includes even the weirdest combinations which may be far from the actual habits of the consumers. Indifference curve analysis studies human behavior effectively only in simple cases, especially those in which the choice is between the quantities of two goods only. Many commodities are not divisible, therefore precise price adjustments cannot be made. Indifference curve technique cannot predict a consumer's behavior when there is risk or uncertainty of expectation as regards the consequences of choice. An individual's consumption is often affected by the level of consumption of others, but this is ignored by the indifference curve analysis. Considering the limitations of this analysis, the theory of consumer's equilibrium must be regarded only as a rough approximation to the actual consumer behavior. However, it is still considered superior to the marginal utility analysis which is given by Marshall.